Well, I am joined magically in our studio from the head of the support department here in Denmark, Ulf Lillegren. And Ulf is here to talk to us about the new security feature of the IQ4, security being something that's completely new to all of our systems that we're just now introducing with the IQ4. You got to start with a new product so you can get in there, make sure everything's nice and secure from the very beginning.
Exactly. This is something new from any product, as far as I know, to have security levels within your camera.
And the security that we're talking about is the same that you have with your iPhone, with your Galaxy. It's a PIN code to access the camera.
Exactly. It's nothing stranger than what you have on your normal cell phone.
Right. And it is entirely optional.
It is.
Which is fantastic. So what are we talking about when we talk about the security? We're talking about the different levels of security.
Absolutely. Any camera bag coming from us doesn't have any security from the start.
Right.
We don't force you either to implement this in any way. It's completely optional. It's important to say because some, you know, people don't want it and some do.
Right.
So the kind of four levels we introduce is a no lock. That means basically it works like any other camera. You turn it on, turn it off, you can do everything.
Right. There's no prompt at all to enter in a security PIN.
None whatsoever.
So basically off.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Second level is lock firmware restored to defaults.
And that would be the lock basic. So it's your basic lock, and it's just preventing you from changing the firmware and wiping out any settings that you have installed in the back.
Exactly. And those settings include, of course, splash screens and backgrounds.
Something custom white balances.
Indeed, and that as well. And those are the kind of things that might be very important for example, a rental studio.
Right. They, of course, don't want somebody out in the field upgrading and downgrading the firmware because then they can't vouch for the behavior of the system.
Yeah.
But a rental studio that preps the job, sends the computer, sends the camera systems, wants it to stay in that firmware version and not be changed.
Exactly.
So the rental studio can set this lock key, this four-digit key, and then the customer can use the camera without any hindrances, but they cannot upgrade, downgrade the firmware. They cannot restore it to default.
Unless they need to on the field where the rental studio can provide a code.
Right, and then they can log in and do whatever they need to do.
Exactly. Second level, lock the user interface.
Right.
This means you can shoot straight up as much as you want, but you can actually not mess with the user interface on the camera back.
Right, so that screen is just locked completely.
Yeah.
Can't touch buttons, can't move anything. Unless you have that key, that's all you're seeing is the keypad.
Yeah.
But the camera works normally.
Yeah, and the kind of scenario we imagined is some kind of setup where you actually are working from the computer tethered while the camera is away and you're afraid that maybe someone start touching and changing, some assistant or whatever it might be.
Right.
Art director. You don't want them to touch the interface of the camera back.
So you can sit at the computer, you can control the camera system from your computer,
yep.
But the camera that's away from you, no one can mess with it.
Exactly.
Yeah, and that's perfect. So you have a little bit of security in that studio environment to know that no one's going to touch a setting on your back and change everything or even, heaven forbid, format the card or something like
exactly.
that while you're out there. So you have a little bit of security from people playing with it.
Exactly.
And then the last one is really the most severe.
Yeah. That is a complete lock. You cannot use the camera without the code. You can't shoot, you can't take a capture without actually entering the code first.
Right, and it works like your iPhone, where you can touch the screen and you have to enter your key to get any further into using the system.
Exactly.
Right.
It's pretty much straight up like any kind of mobile device.
And once you're in, then you can go ahead and you can use it. And if the camera goes to sleep, if the camera powers down, well then when it powers back up or it comes back from sleep, you have to put in the key again.
Exactly.
So that's a really great feature for somebody that's traveling, or when we ship these units, we might want to lock them just in case they get lost in the post or they get stolen, which happens every now and then.
Yeah.
but if it's stolen, then nobody can use it unless they, of course, contact you. And I think that's the important part. There is always a friendly face over in at phase one that can help you recover this
exactly.
key.
Exactly. So it will generate, if you enter the key wrong 5 times, it will actually come up with the serial number of the camera back and a hash key, which we have to contact us in support with.
And that hash key is generated every time that this happens. Every time that you go over your allowance of tries,
yep.
This hash key is generated anew. So there's security in that hash key is, you know, yep. An algorithm is creating that. It's
yep.
not just...
You cannot reboot and think you can get around it. It's
right.
hard there. And, of course, you can contact us and we will... Of course, verify it against our stolen database.
Mm-hmm.
If everything is okay,
right.
We will generate a recovery key.
Right, and then you can plug that in and you can go back to resetting it.
Exactly.
Making it a key that you remember.
Yeah.
Right? Your grandmother's birthday. Or your dog's.
Or 0000.
Or 000. Very secure, 0000. So Ulf, let's show them how this works. So we'll record the screen here, and then they'll be able to see that and walk along with you.
All right. So what we're going to do is we're going to go in and lock and enter the secure code.
000. Very secure, Ulf.
Right. Indeed. And we have changed out.
So that's the lock basic.
Change it to lock basic.
So the lock basic is going to...
If we go out...
To the main menu. And you go down to firmware. So firmware is grayed out. So you can't upgrade the firmware. You can't restore to defaults.
Exactly. So we go back to security settings again.
Right.
And do a lock system.
Right. And then lock it.
We lock it.
Right. And so now all you can see is that PIN code. And you can't capture. You can't do anything with the buttons.
No.
Until you put in your incredibly secure code, there you go. And then you're back in business.
So if we try to do the same thing again, and lock it, and then we try to use the wrong code.
One try, two tries. Oh man, you're running out of room.
There we go.
You get the blue screen of death because our developers have a sense of humor.
Yeah, indeed we do.
So that blue screen shows you the serial number and it shows you your hash key.
Yeah.
And those two items are what you're going to put into a support case. You're going to send it over to Ulf. Ulf's going to verify that it's not stolen. It's not in our stolen database. He might even verify the invoice that the person contacting him is from the same region where the unit was sold. Any measures of security that the support department thinks is necessary. And if they verify that it's you,
yep. Well, the only thing you have to do is shut it off again, start it up again.
Turn it back on, and then you'll give them the login PIN.
Yep.
And they just pop that in.
And the important part here, you have one try to do this.
And then you got to restart the back and move over and over and over again.
Because then, again, if you do this wrong, you will have a new hash key, and you have to do it all over again.
So on and so forth.
Yeah.
And there you go. And you're back into the system.
Indeed.
Yeah, so the security feature that we have in there, I mean, it seems pretty small, but it's really important for such a high-end professional camera system to have that extra level of security, that extra level of comfort. Photographers that travel all the time, people that are shipping these around, rental studios, they just want to have a little bit more control over that system. And so we can provide that with the security setting. And
yeah, I mean, if you ship it and it goes away and gets stolen, lost, or whatever, mm-hmm. That unit is useless for whoever has stolen it, you can say, because if they don't have the PIN code, they can't get through, and if you report it as stolen.
And they'll contact you, of course, if they did steal it back, but we've got super sleuths here, and they'll make sure that it gets back to the rightful owner.
Indeed.
Yeah. Great. Thanks for showing that to us, Ulf.
You're welcome.
All righty.